how can we use Google Docs in our own teaching and learning? In this video, I'm going to show you three concrete examples that you could do either online or in the classroom. Really hope you like the video. These are lovely practical ideas. If you do like the video, please like it. Please share it with other teachers. And I'd love to know of the three ideas, which one you like the best. Let's get started. So let's go over to my Google Docs, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to quickly explain the first example to you and then show you exactly how I did it. So this was an actual class in Zoom. So this was an online session, but this would work perfectly for homework or even in class as well. What I did was I put the students into groups and I gave them a question, which was they were teacher trainers. So I gave them a question to discuss, and then one person in the group wrote the answer. So each group had a group leader. So you can see that this group was, for example, was in room one, and then we got another one down here, room two, etc. Now, the key thing here is that I set up these little boxes before I even shared the Google Docs so that each group knew exactly where to write. So let me show you how I did that, and then let me show you how I shared the link. The important thing to do is to share the link if you're teaching in an online situation, to share the link in the chat window. The students click on the link, they've got the link ready, they've got the Google Doc open, and then get them to go into breakout rooms and to screen share. But let me quickly show you how I did this. So let me go back and create a new doc. So I click on new, come to docs, just click on new document. You just need a blank document. The best thing to do whenever you work with Google Docs, first thing is give it a name. So name your document just so that you can find it, okay? And then what I tend to do is write the question that I want the students to discuss here at the top. So I've written my question here at the top. What do you think of the flipped classroom as a teaching method? And I'm gonna have four groups. So what I next do is I click on insert table, and then I can actually create five groups or five columns like this. I'm going to put here name of group, so then we can have group one, group two, etc. So group one will write here, group two will write here, group three will write here, and group four will write here. And then I normally just move that over, and then this is the space for them to write their ideas. Now what I often do as well is that I make it bigger, so it just gives the students plenty of space to actually write their ideas in, okay? And also that's hopefully encourage them to write a little bit more. So this is the way I set the Google Doc up. Now what I do is I share that Google Doc. Now it's really important when you share the doc to click over here, and you need to make sure that you set it so that everyone can access it. So click here and change the setting to can edit. And then make sure that you click on copy link. Now share that link. If you was in the class, you would share that, put the students into groups, share the link with them. Group one obviously will write here, group two will write here, group three will write here, etc. If the students are working in Zoom or Microsoft Teams and you put them into breakout rooms, then share the link before they go into the breakout rooms. Tell them to click on the link so that they've got it open on their computers. And then when they get into breakout rooms, only one person will need to screen share the document, and then they can all see it on the screen and work with it. So we're on Zoom now. I would just paste that link in and click on enter so that the students could then click on that link before the actual breakout rooms start. And then obviously I would create my breakout rooms. And that will mean that when they get into breakout rooms, one of the students can screen share the document onto the screen so that all of them can see it. And then of course they can start writing it. And I normally say to the person who screen shares the document that it's their responsibility to do the writing. Now, when you've finished the activity, what you can do is come back to the share button and you can close it, you can stop it. So you can click on change and just simply set that to can only view. And that will actually mean now that the students can't write anymore. And then you can bring them back into the main room, open up the doc onto the screen, and obviously discuss what they've written. And that's exactly what I did in the example that I showed you. Okay, so that idea of creating the boxes is really good because it kind of tells the groups where they've got to write. But now what I'm going to show you is a really interesting trick that you can do with Google Docs by simply changing from can edit to can comment. And a lot of teachers don't realize the options that this kind of opens up. So I'm going to take you through a couple of ideas now. Just a super quick 20 seconds break. If you like what you're seeing, please come over to teachertrainingvideos.com. Loads more free videos. There's a special section here on Google. And if you sign up to the newsletter at the moment, I'm also giving away a 12-part training course on how to use technology in teaching and learning. And there are no tricks. Every 3 or 4 days, I send you a video. So great to sign up to the newsletter. You get updated also with all the latest videos, the blog posts, the online courses and the webinars I run. Right, let's get back to the video. So if we look on the screen now, you can see that people have added comments, okay? And there's a really clever way of doing this. So in other words, when you've got a document that's either students have written on, or perhaps a document that you simply want to present to your students and then you want them to comment on it. You don't want them to actually write on the screen, but you want to add comments on the side, like we can see here, perhaps questions, etc. Okay, I'm going to just show you how you can do this. So this can be really interesting in the teaching situation. You present a document to the students, or even it could be a document that they've actually been working on, and then they can comment on each other's. Great for peer feedback. Yeah, so you present a piece of work and then students can comment on it, or perhaps if it's a language teaching situation, they can focus on grammar mistakes, etc. So I'm just going to take you through how this can be done. Let's say afterwards I now want group 1 to comment on group 2's and group 2 to comment on group 1 and group 3 to comment on group 4, etc. and group 4 to comment on group 3, which I could easily do. All I need to do is to come over to the share button and set it. So I need to change it again, but this time I'm going to change it to comment. Okay, now the students can comment on each other's. Now I'm going to click on done and just show you a lovely technique. So let's say that I'm now in group 2 and I've read this and I want to comment on this particular part here. What I do is I can select that and then I can click here and add a comment, and I can say, yes, this is a good point. Okay, and I can add that comment onto the screen. Then perhaps another one, we're discussing more things and we think here we want to add another comment, and again we can click here. So this again would be group 2 looking at group 1's work, etc. Here, yeah, I can comment again. So I often do this where I get the students to comment on a piece of work that perhaps it might even be a piece of work where there's spelling mistakes or where there's grammar mistakes. So great for language work, but also great, for example, for questions where you say, okay, I want you to read this article and think of questions to ask. So it doesn't have to be necessarily a Google Doc that's been produced by the students. It could be simply a story that you've put on the screen on the Google Doc, or an interview, and then the students can simply comment. And again, once you finish the activity, you can click on the share button and turn that off when it's time. Just click on change, set it back to edit, and now no more additional comments can be added. So this technique of selecting and then clicking on the plus button is a great way of getting the students to add comments to the side of the screen. The other nice thing is that afterwards you can review the comments and then you can actually just resolve them by clicking on them. For the last one, I'm going to show you a kind of technique that I use a lot to get students to generate questions. And again, great for language learning, but it could really be for any area of the curriculum. And the idea is I'm going to use the comments idea, but I'm going to do it in a slightly different way. So let me just take you through this now. So what I'm going to do this time is I'm going to grab this here, and it's text about me. I'm just doing it because it's going to save me time. I'm going to copy that text. I'm going to come over and I'm going to create a new document. So I'm going to come over to Docs. I'm going to paste that document in. So we've got the information there. Now what I'm going to do is, as well, I'm going to make this slightly bigger so that it just makes nice space out onto the screen. So we're going to increase the size of the font. Okay, just to make it a little bit bigger like that. Now, What I can do is this one, I'm going to get students to read this document. So this would be a great activity for homework, but it could be done in class. Get the students to read the document and then to think of questions to ask, okay? So for example, let's say that I first start by clicking on the share button, clicking on, make sure that you always give the document a title. So I'm going to call this one interview. Very important, make sure you do that because that means that you can always find the document. Then you're going to click on the share button and you're going to make sure that you set it to anyone can comment again. So we're coming back to that comment one. Now the students can come on, again working in groups or working on their own, it could be for homework, and they've got to think of questions to relate to when they've read this. So good way of kind of really getting them to think about the document in terms of reading. And say for example here, I don't know, there's a, let's say for example this one here, I'm going to click that and click on the plus button and say what did you win an award for? Okay, so you basically get in the students to work with the document and to think of questions to ask. This works really well if it's a story or if it's a context where there's lots of opportunities to ask questions. So for example, question here might be, how long did you, sorry, I keep making mistakes, did you work at Warwick, okay, uni? So you can really kind of get the students to really interact with a text, and this time what they're doing is they're just thinking of questions to ask. Can work nice in the situation if you, for example, get the students to write a little bio about themselves and then share that with another group of students or another individual and get the students to ask questions. Again, once you finish with that, you can click on the share button and then come back down, change that, and then turn that to view, and now nobody can actually comment on the document. Nice little twist on the comments idea that I really have made use of in the past, particularly in language learning contexts. Okay, really hope that video was useful. Please come over to teachertrainingvideos.com. As I said, please make use of the special section on Google. Loads of great ideas around using different Google tools. If you want to keep up with my work, the best thing to do is to sign up to the newsletter. That way you get updated with all the blog posts, the webinars, the online courses, and of course, all the latest videos. You can, of course, subscribe to my YouTube channel. I think there's something like 65,000 subscribers now. And if you were thinking of getting me to do a presentation for your organization, you can contact me from the website. And on the screen now, I'm gonna leave some other videos on using Google tools that you might find interesting. And thank you very much.